Alright, what's up everyone? Pathfinder here, and today we are going to be talking a little bit about the upcoming update, which will probably happen in spring. Now, spring starts on the 20th of March 2018, but I do believe we're going to have some opt-in betas to try out beforehand. And who knows, maybe the full update will come in April? Not really sure. I mean, they didn't like specify when exactly it's going to come out, but they said around springtime, so yeah. Okay, before I actually start reading on what the update's all about, the gameplay in the background, or should I say the map that I'm playing in the background, is called Mayan Arena, and it's going to be linked in the description along with all of the like information to what I'm going to be talking about, so you can read it for yourselves. So yeah, let's jump right into things. So what's going to come in the spring update? Well, the first what we're up to said, the second gift of Krampus Christmas is future knowledge, the knowledge that the MAC-10 SMG will be joining the arsenal in the early part of next year. And you can actually go on there like what we're up to, and they have like a community survey where you can actually go and vote for which weapon's going to come next. And yeah, that's pretty cool. So that's what is going to be linked in the description as well. And they also said the last gift of Krampus Christmas is a message from the past. You, the community, said you wanted an endless mode. And then they said, see you in 2018. Well, so what did we learn from this, what we're up to? Well, pretty much the MAC-10 and endless mode are going to be coming in the early part of 2018. Which is cool stuff. Now let's read a little bit more. Okay, the next what we're up to is named Happy New Year's, a new year, updated plans. So I'm just going to be reading what they had to say here. We have big plans this year to bring you a bigger, better killing floor too. So let's see what is coming. So we're going to get 3 new weapons, an increase by 50% over the last weapon update. So instead of like the usual 2 weapons, we're going to get one extra one. And that extra one is probably going to be like the MAC-10 SMG, because the other 2 are not confirmed yet. And we're also going to get 2 new maps, and one is Tripwire's official map, and one is going to be community made. And I have absolutely no idea which community map it is. Like, genuinely no idea. Okay, we're also going to get endless mode, as I said, and we're going to get a few other surprises. And we're also going to get an old favorite character, and they said, no, not that one, or that one, the other one. Now, they also confirmed that the game will be loaded faster, which is going to be pretty freaking sick if you ask me. I mean, if you have the game on an SSD disk, it doesn't even load that long. But if you don't, you'll be very freaking happy in this next update. And they will also have 2 opt-in betas to try before the actual update releases, which is going to be quite freaking sick. Okay, and now we're going to be heading into the latest what we are up to, which is going to be named Dar 2.0. Now, if any of you are familiar with Killing Floor 1, then you probably know who the hell Dar is. He's the domestic assistant robot, and they said he's going to be a free character for everyone, and you will be able to get additional exoskeletons for the guy with like unlocks that are going to be coming in an upcoming event, and you will be able to get them with unboxing crates and direct purchases from the in-game store. Okay, this is all the information we know thus far. And just before I go and recap on what we're going to get, be sure to share your opinions in the comments, because I'm genuinely quite interested in what you guys have to say about this update. And I do like reading comments, that's just like the highlight of my day. Just replying and reading to your guys' opinions. It's just the freaking best feeling ever, so I'm really grateful for that. Okay, let's recap quickly on what we're going to get in the spring update. So we're going to get a new game mode called Endless Mode. We're going to get 3 new weapons, and one is confirmed to be the MAC-10. And we're going to get 2 new maps. One is confirmed made by the community, while the other one is going to be from Tripwire themselves. And we're going to get an old arguably favorite character, and I say arguably because, I mean, he was obviously not everyone's favorite character, but he's going to be Dar, the domestic assistant robot, and I'm going to be posting some pictures so you guys can actually see what I'm talking about. And the game is just going to get, like, general improvements, and the only thing cool is going to be these, like, two opt-in betas that we're going to have before the update. Okay, so I'm going to be talking, like, in my opinion right now on each of these points, and the first point is the new game mode called Endless Mode. Now, the community, you know, they want Endless Mode and they want Objective Mode slash Story Mode, but I do think that, you know, Objective Mode is, like, more of a priority for Trepoir, because it's just, like, it's unique. You go into a game, you do, like, different objectives, you complete those objectives, and you get, like, an awesome ass experience from that. But Endless Mode, I mean, we already have that, like, mod out, you know, Endless Mode. I already did, like, a bunch of live streams, videos on it. And if you're interested in how that works, then you can go and check him out. But, I mean, even though we get Endless Mode as of right now, it's still pretty freaking decent if you ask me, but I would much rather prefer Objective Mode. But do keep in mind, Trepoir are making Objective Mode. They confirmed that it's going to be, like, in the future, just not right now, so that's pretty freaking cool. Okay, the next point I'm going to be talking about right now are the three new weapons that are going to come in this next update. So, I'm just going to put up some gameplay of the MAC-10 from Killing Floor 1, and I really do adore the MAC-10. It was one of my favorite weapons in Killing Floor 1, just to, you know, go and burn things with. The MAC-10, it's going to be an SMG. I mean, it already is an SMG, and it's going to be both for, hopefully, for the firebug with incendiary rounds and the SWAT. So we're going to get a weapon that is pretty much for two perks, which is actually cool. And on top of that, we're going to get two other weapons that I really have no idea what they're going to be. I mean, I can just assume that one new weapon is going to be for the gunslinger as like a pistol or something, because, I mean, the gunslinger didn't receive any new weapons prior to its release. And for the other weapon, I genuinely have, like, no idea. It's going to be, like, a surprise both for me and for you, probably. And rumor has it, it's not going to be for neither the Survivalist or the Berserker, so it's going to be for one of the other 8 perks, but I still have absolutely no idea what it can be. And I'm not entirely sure about the Gunslinger part, but it has to be, man. The Gunslinger just didn't receive, like, any new weapons. So one is probably going to be for the Gunslinger, but don't take my word for it. But if you ask me, the only weapons that I really want right now are going to be the Tommy Gun, the Sight, maybe even, like, a Chainsaw, the Dwarf Axe, maybe some, I don't know, some dual-wield Glocks or something. Maybe the Glocks are coming to the freaking Gunslinger. I mean, who knows at this point? Maybe, like, even the Riot Shield for the SWAT. But I don't think there's going to be shit for SWAT, because he actually got the UMP fairly recently, so yeah, don't know, but I really want the Tommy Gun, really want the Sight, maybe the Dwarf Axe. That's all I want, and especially the M32, but apparently that's not going to be a thing, so I'm actually kinda sad. But, I mean, we'll see, man. Maybe they'll actually make it someday. Okay, that's all I got for the weapons department. Now let's head into the two new maps that are coming in this update. Now, as I said, one's going to be the community one and one is going to be from Trepoir. Now, the map that I want Trepoir to make is something similar to Zed Landing. You know, that huge-ass volcano that blows up. I just want, like, a map that has, like, you know, different events happening, such as, like, Nuked and, you know, Krampus Lair. But Krampus Lair is, like, its own style of map, so I don't really know about that thing, so I mean, even this map that I'm playing in the background has, like, different, you know, actions that are happening throughout the waves, like the rain, the exploding thing, like the plane. I mean, I just like maps like that. But for the community one, I actually have no idea. It's just, don't even know. Okay, now let's talk a little bit about the character that is coming into the game in this update, the Dar 2.0. Now, in Killing Floor 1, he was not like my, you know, overall favorite. I mean, if you look at my YouTube freaking avatar, you can see which character was my favorite, but I mean, Kevo the Chaw, he doesn't really like fit into Killing Floor 2, so I can kind of understand. And Dar is like this futuristic character, so I kind of expected him when they first came up with, you know, an old favorite. I mean, I personally don't have anything against him. He's, you know, pretty freaking cool. And it's going to be even cooler because you can, you know, get like some unlocks for him. So that's going to be nice as well. So, yeah, arguably favorite character. I mean, I don't have any other opinions on this other than it's cool. And they are finally making improvements to the load time. I mean, I personally don't have a problem loading the game because I have the game on the SSD, but for everyone else, this is going to be quality perfection. And, you know, those two opt-in betas, that's going to be cool as well, because you can actually go and, like, test the game before it actually releases, and hopefully they're going to fix stuff when the game actually updates itself, because Krampus Lair, or should I say Krampus Christmas, they just released them, you know, the Abomination, they, you know, tested him, like, only on one map, I feel, because he's way too freaking easy on any other map, and yeah, hopefully, we're going to test a bit more in these two opt-in betas. And this is going to be probably the end of the video, because I don't have any more information on what's going to be coming out. And I'm going to update you guys on the YouTube community thing, which is actually kind of cool. And let's just quickly recap on what's going to be coming. So a new game mode, Endless Mode, we're going to get 3 new weapons, one's going to be the MAC-10, 2 new maps, one made by the community and the other one from Trepwire, an old favorite character, the Dar 2.0, and we're going to get improvements to the load time, and we're going to get 2 phases of the opt-in beta. And don't forget to leave your opinions in the comments, because I'm genuinely kind of curious on what you guys think on the new weapons and the 2 new maps that are going to be coming. And what are your opinions on Endless Mode, and is it going to be fun, or is it just going to be like boring as hell? And yeah, this is pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed. All the links are going to be in the description as always, and yeah, see you guys next episode. Adios.